Good morning to all my dear students. We will begin with thanking God for this new day in our life, where we all are safe in our home. Students, in our last session, we had started with lesson number 3 of history, that is, religious synthesis. Till now, we have seen about the Bhakti movement, that is, the Alwars and the Nayanars. Then we saw about Ramanuja and the other Acharyas, moving further to Sant Kabir, then in Bengal, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and many others, till we ended with, that is, Narsimha Mehta, who was the first poet of Gujarati language. So let's begin further. Now, today we'll begin with Santa Mirabai. Santa Mirabai, students, was born in 1502 in Rajasthan. Santa Mirabai spread the importance of devotion to Lord Krishna. Students, even though she was born in a royal family of Mewar, she gave up all the pleasures of royal family and all the luxuries and comforts of life, left everything and completely dedicated herself to the devotion of Lord Krishna. Devotional verses were composed by her in Rajasthani and Gujarati languages. People got attracted to such sant because they saw some new ways of devotion which they could practice. They liked it. Now, when she composed the verses which were liked by many, what message did these verses give to the people? Her devotional verses, students, gave the message of devotion, which we have seen in detail about what is devotion in our last session, that is bhakti. Tolerance, that is, we have to be tolerant about what? About the things happening in life. She was of the opinion that we should not be violent and react against things not happening according to our way. So, one should be tolerant. One should show humanity to fellow beings. Now, to be humans and show compassion and mercy to the fellow beings. Such messages was given by Santa Sena and Santa Rohidas too. Her compositions are admired, students, even today by many people. Next, we are going to study about Surdasa. See on your screen, you can see the image. Surdasa was a great poet of Hindi literature who composed the poetical work Sur Sagar. He was also a great devotee of Krishna. Krishna Bhakti was the main theme of his poetical work or the poems that he wrote on. Now, students, not only Surdasa, but there were many others, those who composed poems on various deities. The verses on Krishna Bhakti composed by a Muslim son, Rakshan, are melodious. Ramcharitra Manas of Sant Tulsidas is a beautiful composition expressing devotion to Rama. Sant Tulsidas condemned the traditional thinking of the Pandit and believed that do not discriminate anyone but see that all are respected, all are given the respect because everyone is equal before God. Next, students, we are going to learn about Basaveshwar. In Karnataka, Basaveshwar, who was born in 1105 AD, himself a Brahmin, spread the Lingayat, that is, the Saiva sect of South India. Now, we have already learned, students, that different forms of devotion emerged in different parts of India and how and why according to the local situation there. Now, Basaveshwar was also against the caste system. See, I told you, he was a Brahmin, but still he was against this and stressed and gave more emphasis to dignity of labor. He rejected gender or social discrimination. Now, dignity of labor, students, what is that? It is the philosophy wherein all types of jobs are respected equally and no occupation is considered superior and none of the jobs should be discriminated on any basis. All should be treated equally. He wanted that only, students. He wanted the labor to be treated equally. Basaveshwar, students, spread social awareness through his poetry, popularly known as Vachanad. Kaya Kaga Kailaj is his well-known saying, which means work is Kailaj, that is, work is worship. He was the one who encouraged women also to participate in such movements. Men and women belonging to all castes began to participate in the religious discussion conducted in the hall Anubhava Mantapa. See, he gave opportunity to everyone because he considered everyone is equal. Now, Anubhava Mantapa welcomed men and women from all socio-economic backgrounds to discuss spiritual and other questions of life in open. He, Basaveshwar, preached in the language of the people that was spoken by them, that is, Kannada. He spread the message through his preaching of simple living and clean and pure behavior. His writings, students, had an immense influence on the society. Sri Basaveshwar conveyed his teachings, I told you, in the simple language that was spoken by the people through the medium of Vachana literature. His followers have composed their work in Marathi also. Of this composition, Param Rasya, composed by Manmath Swami, is very well known. Other great sung in Karnataka during this time include Pan, Purandar Dasa and others. Purandar Dasa was another great son of Karnataka. He composed many devotional songs in Kannada. Even today, they are popular among the people. So, see, students, here, as I told you, in different parts of our country, this bhakti movement had started. Those who encouraged and gave a bhakti mark to people for devotion. Our next topic, students, and the topic is Mahanubhav Pant. In the 13th century, Chakradar Swami founded this Mahanubhav Pant in Maharashtra. He propagated a religious as well as social movement in which all members were accepted irrespective of their caste. So, you are also students, you will notice that he wanted to preach to the people that all are equal before God, right? So, no one is of high caste or low caste. And he also preached to them about the traditional ritualistic religion, which was rejected. So he did not give importance and told the people not to give importance to ritualism, the rituals, right? So he preached the people about, you're going to see, that is the equality of caste, and against, he was against the ritual system. This sect preaches devotion to Krishna, Lord Krishna. Shri Govind Prabhu was the guru of Chakradhar Swami. The followers of Chakradhara included both men and women. Now, men and women belonging to all castes of high and low and creed, that is of all faith. So, he gave opportunity for both men and women to be the followers, his followers, and accept the preachings and the teachings that he gave them. Chakradhar Swami supported equality, and that's why we saw that he gave opportunity for both men and women. So he traveled, students, to all parts of Maharashtra, and while he traveled and did his preaching, he saw to it that he uses Marathi language, the language that was spoken by the common people. He did not preach to them in Sanskrit, which was difficult for the common man to understand, but he used their own language, and because of this, the language that he used, Marathi language, led to the development of Marathi language. Many of his followers, those who composed the poems, they did it in Marathi. That further facilitated the Marathi literature. On your screen you can see a map, that is map of Maharashtra. So this sect, that is Mahanubhav Panth, mainly spread in the Vidarbha and Marathwara regions of Maharashtra. Riddhipur in Vidarbha is an important place for people of this sect. Students, this sect did not spread only in Maharashtra, but reached to the far away regions. See, again, you are going to see on your screen the map, and the regions it spread to were Punjab and Afghanistan. So it spread in Maharashtra and reached up to Punjab and Afghanistan, had its followers in these regions too. Next is, do you know? Some of the main compositions of the followers of the Mahanubhav Panth are the treatise Lila Charitra, compiled by Mindbird, describing the deeds of Chakradhar Swami, Davale, of the first Marathi poetess Mahadamba, Sutrapath and Rishtantapath, compiled by Keshobas, Vacharan of Damodar Pandit, Shishu Palwada of Bhaskar Bhatt Borikar, and Rukmini Swayamvara of Narendra. The next one is Guru Nanak. Students, Guru Nanak was the founder of Sikhism, and he was the first guru of Sikh. His work has to be mentioned as a great attempt at religious synthesis. Now, religious synthesis, we have seen the meaning of synthesis, that is a change that has to be brought. Okay? why it is said so? That he did a great attempt at religious synthesis to bring about new ideas and idols. Why? Because he was the one who visited the holy places, both of Hindus and Muslims. He also visited the holy place of Muslim, that is Mecca. After visiting these places, what did he realize? Or what was his feeling after visiting both the places of Hindus and Muslims? He realized that the devotion is common everywhere. See, people belong to different religions, but the way of worshipping the God, the way of their devotion, he felt is common everywhere. So, he taught to the people that all persons must be treated equally. Now, again, we are coming across this, that all are equal before God. He was also of that same opinion. His teaching aimed at Hindu-Muslim unity, because considering that God is one and we are equal before God. Like we saw when we learned about the saints earlier in the same chapter, that is, they taught by using the common language and the people got influenced by that. In the same way, when Guru Nanak taught them that all are equal or must be treated equally, many people were influenced by his teaching. Thus, the number of his followers started increasing day by day. See, students, the number of his followers of Guru Nanak increased day by day. And these followers of Guru Nanak came to be known as Sikh, that is Shishyas, meaning disciple, those who followed on his ways and his preachings. The Adi Grantha, also called Grantha or Granth Sahib, the sacred scripture of Sikhism, a religion of India. It is a collection of nearly 6,000 hymns of the Sikh gurus and religious leaders besides various saints. Besides the Sikh gurus, that is the religious leaders, and various early and medieval saints also contributed to the collection of hymns, and among these were Sant Namdev, Sant Kabir and other santas, disrespective of the different religion and caste, because that was the preaching of Guru Nanak, and he had visited Hindus and the Muslims places, that is the holy places. So their contribution was also taken by him in their holy scripture, that is Adi Grantha or Granth Sahib. After the death of Guru Nanak, students, he was succeeded by 9 gurus of the Sikh. Guru Gobind Singh, as you can see it on your screen, he was the 10th guru of the Sikh. After Guru Gobind Singh's death, the Sikh regard the Guru Granth Sahib as their guru as per the orders that were given by Guru Gobind Singh. The last topic of our lesson, we are going to learn about the Sufi sect, that is the Sufi religious group. Sufism has a history in India, students, evolving for over 1000 years. The presence of Sufism has been a leading entity
increasing the riches of Islam throughout South Asia. This is a sect in Islam. The Sufi sense, what did they believe in? They believed that God is full of love, and the only way to reach God is by loving Him and worshipping Him, and that the one can do through the devotion, right? So they preached the people that love God, right? Devote Him, pray to Him, worship Him, and you are going to get that inner feeling or the inner love you are going to experience. That was the main teaching of Sufism. Another teaching of Sufism was to love all human beings. This we have seen earlier when we saw the movements taking place in different parts of our country. That is, show compassion, show mercy, show humanity. Now that was also preached here. That is to love all human beings. Another thing that they told the people here is to do meditation. Meditate and try to be one with God. And once leaving the people, the way of living, it should be simple. The living of the people should be very simple. So that was the main preaching of Sufism. Loving all human beings, meditation, and simple living. So on the screen, students, you can see two images. And these two images are of Khwaja Moinuddin Chisti and Sheikh Nizamuddin Awliya, where they were the great Sufi saints. Teaching of saints led to the unity in the Hindu-Muslim communities. Sufi music has made valuable contribution to Indian music, right? So they wanted the unity. Why? Because they considered that we all are one. God is one and we all are equal. So this led to the unity in the Hindu-Muslim communities. Lastly, we conclude with the lesson. That is what we have learned in this lesson. The part of bhakti, that is devotion, taught by the santas, various santas in various parts of our country, were easy to follow for the common people. And why? Once again, we will revise, because this santa, they taught about their movement in the language that was spoken by the common people. The bhakti movement was open to all men and women. So women were also considered equal, and the rights were given to the women. The santa expressed their thoughts in the language of the people. The common people found them close to their heart. The language that was used, they understood the preachings of the different santas in different parts of the country. When the santa spoke in their own language, they felt their language to their heart. And that's why many followers in different parts of country, they took part in different movements. The bhakti movement has contributed greatly to the making of the Indian culture. So this is the end of our lesson, where we have seen various movements taking place in different parts of our country. Students, here we have completed with our third lesson of history, that is religious synthesis. In our next session, that is online session, we will discuss with the workbook exercises. Till then, I want you to read the lesson and mark down the answers of objective questions in your textbook. So this is all for today, students. Thank you.